So I invite session chair Professor Bipin Agarwal sir for importance of the theme and about the topic so that he will enlighten about the theme of environment protection webinar series and the theme of food waste management. So I invite Professor Bipin Agarwal sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, pretty audible, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. Once again, I thank Econ Services and Dr. Ashok Rathorji for inviting me as the chairperson for the 14th session of this webinar series on environment protection and public health. The theme of today's session is food waste management. The expert guest speaker of today's session is Dr. Manoj Tripathi, who is a principal scientist at the Central Institute of Agriculture Engineering, Bhopal. Food wastage occurs along the entire food chain from field to table. As much as it is an ethical issue on one hand, it also leads to economic losses and has negative impact on the environment. Food wastage is therefore considered as a significant problem for modern society, and the first step in solving it is to identify and understand the reason for its emergence in each part of the food chain and various specific sectors. In order to create practices and recommendations aimed primarily at preventing food wastage, the categorization and quantification of food waste is highly essential. The food waste management should be an integral part of management in each and every sector where food is being utilized in one form or the other, primarily because an effective food safety management system is the starting point for implementing most of the practices that lead to both safe final product and reduction of food waste. Food waste exists along the entire food chain, starting with agriculture production, post-harvest treatment and storage, and it continues through food production, distribution, consumption and end of life. That is, it covers everything from field to table. However, in order to understand the scope of this problem, the term food loss and food waste must be distinguished. According to Food and Agriculture Organization, food loss refers to decrease in mass, that is dry matter quantity, as well as the nutritional value or the quality of food that was originally intended for human consumption. Whereas food waste refers to food deemed appropriate for human consumption being discarded, regardless of whether it is kept beyond its expiry date or left to spoil. That is why when it comes to food waste in general, regardless of its occurrence and its place in the food chain, the term food wastage is used. Food wastage refers to any food lost by worsening or by being discarded. Thus, the term wastage covers both food loss and food waste. Food loss occurs mostly during the earlier phases of the food chain, which may be due to the limited post-harvest infrastructure and underdeveloped technologies. In contrast to this, food waste occurs mainly in the consumption phase, and so it is primarily the responsibility of consumers, reflecting their behavior and attitude towards food. Without taking much of your time, I would request the organizers to invite Dr. Manoj Tripathi to present some important aspects of the food waste management. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. for the importance and the, of course, this is a need of an hour that we have to utilize the food and that the food can be converted into the wealth. For that purpose only, we have an eminent speaker, Dr. M.K. Tripathi, Principal Scientist, ICARCIA, Bhopal. Dr. Tripathi is a postgraduate in biochemistry from Dr. RMLA University, and he obtained PhD in biochemistry from G.B. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar, Uttarakhand. He is currently working as a principal scientist, biochemistry, at APPDICARCIAE, Government of India, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. His major area of research or professional interest include medicinal compound, functional and nutraceutical food, fermented and probiotic food. He has guided more than 50 PG students. He has published more than 85 research papers in International Nations Journal of Repute, 93 abstract, 54 book chapters and 55 popular articles. He has authored, edited more than 15 books and 5 technical bulletins in area of food processing, food biotechnology. 2 books received award for book of the year and book bestseller book. He has developed more than 25 processes technology, worked on 16 national projects as a principal investigator and co-PI, group leader of PMO-based activity on food-based carbonated beverage development. Patent applied for 6 products, commercialized many processes technologies and registered gene in NCBI. Received several research grants from NASF, ICAR, DST, Ministry of Environment and handled more than 25 administrative and expert responsibility. Has been a recipient of several prestigious awards and honors like qualified prestigious CSIR Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Fellowship in 2002. So I invite our speaker to enlighten about the theme or food waste management, how this can be managed and how this food can be converted into the wealth. So I'm just sharing the screen. I think screen is visible, right? So can we are shifting to the another one. Can you see the screen right now?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Over to you, sir.
I am audible?
Yeah, pretty audible.
Yeah. And first of all the respected dignitaries and participant, and I wishing you all a very happy Independent Day, specifically 75 Bharat Amrit Mahotsav. I am very thankful to the Dr. Ashok and his group for organizing such types of webinar in COVID-19 pandemic, which is really required. So before going to any other thing, I just come to my topic. If you see the topic itself indicate the how can we convert the waste to wealth and what are the different scenario in basically in food industry. So how can we manage and utilize for the wealth purpose is very important, food wastage. Before going to the food wastage, next, please, if you see this slide, why this slide? If you see this is the current scenario of our country where we are the either in first, second, third, are in different perspective, we are the very much in production, and not in production, we have very good agroclimatic regions, largest arable lands, largest net irrigated areas, cultivated lands, major climates, all are favorable for us. So it indicates that we have a very significant opportunities in the this horticulture and other crops. If you see the production is high, definitely if we utilize all the product in properly, then it will be okay. If we are not able to utilize, then in that conditions, same thing is going on. Means we are just producing higher and higher such type of thing, and also producing higher amount of the byproduct. So this is important. Either the production, that's why their utilization of the byproduct generated from their industrial perspective or agriculture perspective is very important. Next, please. If you see the production, everywhere the production is going to very high. If you see the scenario of 17 and 18, in case of vegetable, 187 metric ton, 3.5% more than that of the 16 previous year. Same case is the fruit. Means the production become very high. Means we are producing huge amount of this commodity. Next. So, why this waste generation and byproducts utilization very important? If you see, this is the actually the scenario of the different country where these byproducts are not utilized. If you see the Australia 361, United States, this is the actually status of all the country where this loss indicates. We are also in the very good, not in a good condition of the utilization. So this scenario is very dramatic, and we are not in a very comfortable zones in the form of the wastage and byproduct, because these wastage are not only wealth, but they are also causing them several problematics into the environment. Means if this wastage is dumped in the environment, definitely so many of the health and other reasons are created during environment. If we convert it to the wealth, definitely they become the value-added compounds and value-added product, and play a very major role in our economy. Next. And so if you see the percentage waste in globally, overall 13.8% wastage are dumping in the environment as well as in dustbin. So if in that 13.8, the roots, tuber, and this is the scenario for the root and vegetable, meat and animal product, cereal and pulses, means we are just disposing, we are wasting a huge amount of the food product. And these food products are not only wasted, but these products are very rich in the nutrient. So they are the major cause for the invitation of several pathogenics in the environment. So the immediate utilization of this byproduct and is very much required. If you see the scenario of food wastage in India, the food that goes to the dustbin in India is left unused and could be the only meal of the day for about 194.6 million people of the India. You can imagine how much we are wasting and how can we utilize it. India wasted 44,000 crore worth of the food everywhere. Every year, roughly one third of the food produced in the world for human consumption. Every year, approximately 1.3 billion tons. Means we are just producing huge amount of the our production, but you are also losing a huge amount of the commodity in the form of wastage. Next. So if you see, this is the a simple chart, what were the stages and where we are losing in different farm. If you just start from the agriculture and harvested the commodity, during harvest, there are several food wastage generated, like twig, leaves, straw, parts of the plant, waste commodity, unsuitable for the food market, just generated during this stage. When they harvested and goes to the market, full product, this step also a huge amount of byproduct and wastage are generated in the form of fruit stone, fruit pulp, fruit skin. So huge amount of wastage is also generated at this stage. When this marketable product processed and converted to the processing products in the different farm, again huge amount of byproduct generated in this stage. So if you see each and every stage of this agriculture to the processed product, huge amount of byproducts are generated. Next. Please, next. Sokji, please, next. So if you see, these are the some food sources near to our house, near to in other institute or commercial mode or in our kitchen. If you should see the residential, the hometowns, our townhouses, apartment, all are the responsible for causing huge amount of wastage. In commercial source, office, cafeteria, shopping malls, hotels, airport, restaurant. If you see the institutional cases, some gurdwara, mandir, school, hospital, everywhere these food byproducts are generated. Industrial cases, also huge amounts of food wastage generated. Next, please. And if you see the kitchen wastage, specifically kitchen wastage, because our kitchen's wastage is mainly full of nutrient. If you dump this nutrient in the environment, this immediately invite to the several pathogen. So this kitchen wastage basically categorized in three category. It may be avoidable, some possible avoidable, and some unavoidable. So in case of these two group, avoidable and possible avoidable, if you take the technology, if you utilize the technology, we can convert it into edible wastage. And finally, can be utilized. In some cases, there are some unavoidable. You cannot be convert to the edible form, like waste arising from the food preparation that is not and has been edible under normal circumstances. So these are some kitchen wastage which can be converted to the edible and non-edible. Next, please. So if you see, basically this food wastage basically categorized in two wastes. Right? In some country, this food wastage is more prevalent, and it happened when the edible food is just discarded prematurely or unnecessarily. Means there is no reason, they just discarded prematurely. In that is the basically case of the waste generated in the Americans. So in other cases, this food loss is the more prevalent, and it happened when food is damaged or destroyed before the consumer can eat. Means there are some reasons, either transport either due to the storage. So this loss is basically in the poor country and the African country. Next is, so if you see, these are the total percent loss in the world sources. So everywhere this food losses is going on, either in the industrial Asia or South and Southern Asia, North America. In some country, they are just utilizing this byproduct to the some value added. Means they have developed several technology to conversion of this wastage to the byproduct. In our country, this we immediately require to development of several technologies to just control the wastage. Next. Next, please. So if you see the food wastage, these are the basic, how can we utilize and how can this food wastage come to the food supply? Basically, this food wastage, food chain wastage and domestic wastage comes. In some cases, they are very traceable. In some cases, the poor traceable. In some cases, it just comes in the form of pollutants. So if you see the first organic crops, here the this residue is the highly traceable. It may be converted to the animal food and also can be utilized for the extraction of several valuable compounds. Technology is there. In other cases, cafeteria wastage, that is again poor in traceability, but it can be utilized in the biofuel, bioenergy production, and biological treatment is required. In case of some animal byproduct, where they just come to the pollutant because of the poor traceability, and we have no proper technology. So in that cases, they also can be converted to the category and can be recovered to the several valuable compound. And in case of packaging, food packaging is also causing very pollutant, and that pollutants are also poor traceability, but they can be cycling and composting in the form of landfill. And if you see the mixed food wastage, where heterogeneity of different food industries there, so it can also utilize in the energy recovery, anaerobic digestion, recycling and landfill. But in case of domestic wastage, where no duty of the care applies, and they can be directly utilized for the our farming or landfill and incineration and other anaerobic digestion for the production of several compounds. Next, please. So this value-added applications of industrial wastage can be in several ways. We can utilize for the enzyme production, for biofuel production, from pigment production, variable polymer production, biotic component product, food value. Means basically these value-added products in our institute, and we are also working to just converting this food byproduct and agriculture wastage in for the food application as well as energy application. So there is a huge potential of development of different sector for the utilization. Next, please. So if you see this different utilization, means the feed stakes that can be converted into residue, energy crops, forest residue, organic waste, and these all are the source for this purpose. They just converted into some intermediate in the several processing stages and technological intervention, like convert sugars, intermediate chemical building blocks, biofuel, gas waste picture. Again, they can be, means this feed stake and this intermediate can be converted finally into value-added products like fuels, chemical, and power. So there is a huge potential of this byproduct to conversion of value-added compound. So if you see, this is the health benefits of this food wastage. We are working on the food wastage, like the vegetable, fruit, cereal, and soybean. And we are extracting several chemicals in the phenol and phytochemicals. And these all chemicals have very good health benefits in the different health sector, like Alzheimer's disease, anti-cancer. Means if you see the health benefit, it itself indicate that these food wastage can be converted into a and can be convert in a very good food industry sector for the just generating several wealthes. Next, please. Next. So if you see this food derived, means there are two basic groups, where one from the food wastage and some is the animal derived food wastage. So this technology, we are this process like extraction processing, and we are just concentrating on this processing and developing lipids, cellulose, some biotic compound, pectin, and then we are just working on the huge compound extraction from this food wastage. And by incineration, we are just also working on hydrogels. In some cases, after the pre-treatment analysis, we are converting some unutilized and highly nutritious compound to the their hydrolyzed form for the several purposes, like enzyme production, for the culture media production, and some bioplastics. So in case of the animal derived products, basically we are using anaerobic digestion and converting the biofertilizer, and also some animal based products which are used in the food industry for the packaging as well as shelf life enhancement like collagens, protein hydrolysis, fatty peptide. Means if you see in both the cases, plant derived or animal derived, huge amount of food wastage is generated and opportunities to conversion of different bioactively compound is high. Next, please. Next, please. So if you see, these are the different steps in different commodity like cereal, food. Everywhere the food percentage of food wastage is different. Means there are several steps where there is a probability to product generation of wastage like consumption stage, distribution stage, processing stage, post-harvest stage and primary production stage. So if you see all the cases, all the commodities like cereal, this wastage is different in different stages. In some cases, the processing stage is responsible for the major waste generation. In some cases, distribution stage is responsible. In some cases, post-harvesting. In some cases, their storage is problem. So in all the commodity, the problem is not same, but in most of the different commodity, a different problem is there that causing the more and more waste generation. Next. Please, next. So if you see the waste byproducts in the some production study where we are working, and the white wine production, this waste is 20 to 30% waste is generated. Red wine, 20 to 30%. Fruit and vegetable juice production, 30 to 50% wastage are generated during this industry. Fruit and vegetable processing, again, this wastage is very high. If you see the vegetable oil production, 40 to 70% wastage are generated. The huge amount of waste is generated. In case of sugar production from sugar beet, 85% waste is generated. Man, you can imagine how much waste is generated and we are just degrading. Why this wastage is not suitable for environment, not eco-friendly, because they are poor biological stability, they degraded very easily, significant nutritional value, so they invite more and more microbes, high concentration of organic compounds, high water reactivity, poor oxidative stability, optimum enzyme activity. These are the reason why these food wastage are not favorable for store and unfavorable for their storage and protection. So this poor waste management play a vital role in the growth different way. In case if you see in some cases, some food industry like fruit and beverage, soybean production, starch and edible oil, the waste water, some water generated during the production stage, like if you see here, soybean product. If you see the soybean product utilized for the food purpose, we just develop a paneer. In case of paneer development, a huge amount of paneer water, yeah, tofu whey is generated. If you imagine 1 kg of the soybean just to produce 7 to 8 liter of whey, and that whey are highly nutritious. If this nutrition is spread in environment, a huge amount of the microbial contaminants occur. When they put in the ponds, there is a water blooming, means this byproduct and this wastage water from the different industry is also problematic. If we can utilize, they again become the source of our income. So if you can see, there are several technology we are using like membrane technology, foam fractionation, adsorption coagulation technology, and solvent and noble extraction technology. And their waters are just converting in some nutraceutical, some biological compounds and antioxidant source. Next, please. Please, next. So if you see our fruit and vegetable commodity from apple, banana, citrus, these are the some wastage in this industry. And if you see, we have the major losses and wastage in this industry. In case of banana, 35 to 50% wastage generated due to their peels, citrus 50%. Means every commodity producer is huge amount of wastage, and that wastage are not simply wasted, that wastage are highly nutritious. Means if you can utilize this wastage, it becomes a good source of value compounds. But when you just dump in the environment, it becomes very a good source for the microbial contamination. So their loss is the our economy loss. Next, please. So if you see, this is why we are asking. If you see in all the byproduct cases, there are a very good amount of protein, very good amount of fat, carbohydrate. Means all these byproducts which is we just dump in environment, in dump in anywhere, is a huge source of, it may be the good source of protein, fats and other. Why this they just invite to the microbes? So that means they have a good potential, they have a high potential for their utilization due to their huge nutritional potential. Next, please. If you see, this is the some soya byproducts, where these three, tofu were just generated in the paneer stage, soya whey, the soya protein isolates and okra, these are the three common byproducts. If you see, all are the very good source of oligosaccharide, good source of protein, good source of fat, good source of minerals, but due to the technological problem, due to the not well developed technology, the peoples are not using is a source of value compound. They are just dumping in environment. If they are dumping there, if you see these two stickio and raffinose, these are the two very good source of oligosaccharides, and they are very favored for the microbes. Means if you dump to the environment, definitely they can microbial degrade easily. And these two are the very good source of prebiotics. Nowadays, this is the age of probiotics. Everyone just asking for the probiotic. If you see the in the case of the COVID pandemic, everything is, we are very limited, like vaccine is not available, medicinal facilities are very limited, oxygen is limited, but the foods are the only factor which can available at that time, and everyone asking WHO and all the, this health community to take immunity boosting food. So this immunity boosting the probiotics are the major, and these probiotics require some prebiotics. So these are the becoming a very good source for the food industry, for their economy, but the technology is required. Next please. So if you see food wastage and byproduct, why this food wastage is the wastage, and how this food wastage become is the a good source or wealth. If you see, this is the agriculture product, agriculture production in goes to the food industry. In this food industry, they directly used for the several products. When they utilize the product, that is okay. But during this product formation, several food wastage and byproduct generate. If this food wastage and byproduct dumped into the environment, it causes several environmental losses. That's why the food pollution control board always strict to utilization of this byproduct. If you utilize operating several processing, definitely they causes the cost causes to the products. Though in that case it become very very high cost. But when see this composition of this food waste and byproduct, they are very good source of protein, lipids, carbohydrate, fiber. And if you utilize properly, it become very good source of food additive. And if you see, they are the very good source of compound. And that is the drawback of this food waste. But when you by using several processing technology, if you minimize or remove this anti-nutritional sources, this becomes the one of the balanced food for the animal. So in both way, for the animal or food, if you use the food additive by several processing technology, it becomes the food, can be converted directly food or food product, and these food product may be the source of industrial. So their utilization is very important. That's why if you see this fruit vegetable, if you develop several processed products and these are the byproducts just generated during this, this can be converted into production of various biotic compounds like pharmaceuticals, nutraceuticals, healthcare sector, chemical industry, and food sector. So they have a huge potential, and by using some processing and technology, it can be converted into very good value-added products. So this is the, if you see, these are the some fruit vegetable waste byproducts like peels, pulp, stalk and seed, and they are good source of natural compounds or some source of the biotic compounds. And by using several technology, by drying, distilled fermentation, green extraction technology, ultrasound, this technology that converted this byproduct to the for the value added are directly to the food nutrition, food fortification, novel functional food ingredient, are as a different in sort like island. Case of dairy products, converted into prebiotic and anti-inflammatory supplement by technology. In meat industry, the byproduct can be converted into protein hydrolyzate, and they have very good potential in the pharmaceutical industry. So you can see this agri food wastage have a several applications after conversion to the their value-added compound. Next. So this I am just showing this. If you see the food wastage, it become one of the good source of phytonutrient. It can be good source of biotic compound and dietary fiber by different methods. So two methods we are using: enzymatic treatment and fermentation treatment, and their compounds are their supplement we are using for the several health purposes, which is either in the form of supplement, either in the form of the fortified foods. Next. And then so if you see, this plant byproducts are rich and available compound and can be utilized in various food industries. So these are the some list of food industry where we are working. We can convert these novel and cost economical a natural source of food grade nutrient media for the microbial culture or probiotic culture, starter culture, prebiotics, dietary fibers, antioxidant, pectin, enzyme, organ. We are converting this byproduct to the different source as an industry purpose. Next. So these are the valuation of this byproduct. Means if you are a very basic technology, if you are a physical method, it can be converted. This waste can be converted for the recovery of ions, recovery of proteins, recovery of oligosaccharide, recovery of isoflavone. Means these are the some list of some compound which can be just obtained by some physical method. When we using the some microbiological enzymatic method, several products you can produce by that. You can produce peptide production, production of prebiotics, hydrogen production, novel ingredient in dairy products in the form of supplements or food fortified ingredient, culture for the patho testing, citric acid production, cultivation for the probiotics. We are also working on this lactic acid bacteria production. We are just replacing these five products as a natural coagulant for the paneer and tofu production, fungal micellar protein. So if you see, there is a huge potential of conversion or valorization of this food byproduct if you're using a various methods. Next. So these are the some applications where we are working. We are working on the microbiological culture media by just by converting these byproducts. We are also using for the algal production, probiotic culture production. We are using fermentation media. We are using novel ingredient, dairy and food dairy production. Means these are the some applications where we are directly working on the food byproducts for the different purpose. Next, please. So next, so these are the some list. We are also concentrating on the bacteriocin production, fungal food, functional food beverage we are developing from the byproduct, natural tofu coagulant we are producing, prebiotics we are producing, and protein hydrolysis for the probiotic culture as well as advanced culture for the different microbial community. We are also developing using these byproducts. So these are the some interventions. Next. So just simply we try to ask what are you doing? Actually, if you see, this is the paneer, and if you make the soya milk, so this is the soya bean, you can convert in the soya milk, and this soya milk after coagulation can be tofu. So this is the byproduct okara, one of the major byproduct in this industry, and this is again tofu where the byproduct. Actually, these byproducts are highly nutritious. Next. And due to this nutritious, due to the this nutritional property, it can, if you dump in the any way, they just invite microbial. But these byproducts and this waste have a high nutrient value, and they are the prebiotic and texturizing additive. Their capability of cosmetic, pharmaceutical, and food industry, good source for the microorganism in the fermentation and cheap culture media. So these are the potential, and due to this potential, we are converting this one of the major byproduct in the, as a culture media for probiotic production. Means I just happy to share, we are producing our own culture media for the our probiotic production. We have recently developed a probiotic soya cheese spread and several fermented products where we are just using not a commercial media, we are just using our culture media, and this media, culture media, is also in the stage of the final stage of the patent. So directly this tofu culture media just converted, this water converted into wealth for the production of probiotic production. Next, please. These are the sub experimental starter. We are also developing soya milk. Actually, this soya milk have some beany flavor and some flatulence causes. For that, we are just fermenting this, and all the fermenting media we are using are basically the this soybean byproduct derived. So after this fermentations from the this byproduct, it become more favorable for the use and health value. So this is the products we are developing. Next. Here, probiotic soya cheese spread is also developing, which is the probiotic in nature, and all the probiotics in this products is comes from the byproduct fermentation, and byproducts is basically the from the soybean byproducts. So, for the maintaining their viability, for just retaining the probiotic property, and for the fermentation, we are just using some of the byproducts like okara products and tofu product in the soya cheese spread. We are also developing soya. And in this cases, our byproducts for the fermentation media is also playing major role in the conversion of cheese byproduct. And this product is specifically soya milk powder, including probiotics. So this is the our developed probiotic soya milk powder, and which is also in stage of commercialization. Next, please. So this one of the byproduct from the rice hull is now we are just converting and. Converted to the some of the culture media and found a very good result when replacing them some concentration of the MRS media by using this hydrolysis, rice hydrolysis. It's showing the better growth for the probiotic. So in future it can be replaced or it can be one of the supplement for the rice culture media. So next, please. Next, please. So if you see this result, this is the hydrolysis and this is the different concentration where microbes are going. If you see, this is the one of the important intervention of the byproduct, if you this is the tofu and food industry, basically in food industry where we paneer is prepared, if you go to the market, there is not availability of the food grade chemicals. People are using the chemicals, but they are not aware of the food grade chemicals. So we just developed this tofu, one of the byproduct ferment, and after fermentation and some adding some byproducts, we just developed a powder form which is just a coagulant. So if you see, this is the our byproduct, to prepared tofu. Please previous slide, please, 1 minute. Yeah, this is the tofu, this is the paneer prepared from the byproducts. Simply this is the natural, there is no chemical, and this is the tofu or paneer prepared by the magnesium chloride. So this byproducts formulated coagulant are doing excellent work. So here there is no residue of chemical, so this is again one of the best utilization of this byproduct in the food industry. Next please. And next please. Next, we are also using directly this product and fermented and for the production of antioxidant, and these are the some products that these byproducts are converting into the and beverage. These are the fermented beverage where this is the actually byproducts of the some of the commodity which is in the form of fermented and probiotic beverage. Next please. Next please. So we are also developing some fermentation media, which is the which is very much required. If you see the some of the our commodity like millets have a very huge amount of potential, huge amount of health benefit, but they have some, when we make a flour, their shelf life decreases. So in that cases we develop a fermentation media where we increase their shelf life and also reduce their some of the antimicrobial compound and some of the anti-nutritional compound. And this is again one of the industry product which we are just commercialized. These are the some fermented products which developed from the these byproducts by several intervention. Next, these products are also in stage of the commercialization. There is a one product we developed in our lab, that is the sauerkraut, which is the very common fermented products in the South African. But here we developed the probiotic sauerkraut by using this byproduct. So here our culture media and some of the ingredient of the byproducts are using for the development of probiotics. So a normal sauerkraut we develop in the probiotic sauerkraut by using some byproduct. If you see, these are the some work we are working on the development. We just developing this byproduct specifically from the liquid byproduct and solid byproduct from the fruit, vegetable and cereal, and that converted to the prebiotics sources for several food and ingredient sources and pharma sources by converting this as a probiotic and fermented products. Next. And if you see, this is the one of the important area we are working, that is the we are just working to convert our byproducts to the culture media for the microalgae. And we have also succeeded. We have recently published one papers on this, which is a very high NAS rating. So you can estimate, if you just develop the culture for the microalgae, definitely this microalgae which have a very beneficial role in the industry and food industry. So this, see, there are several ways the people are producing the microalgae, but this culture media is a problem. That's why, due to the high cost of this culture media, this product is very costly. So in that case, if we convert our waste and byproduct to the culture media, definitely their cost will be decreased. We are also working on the just developing some byproducts by several biochemical and processing method and extraction methods to the flavor directly. So these products, these stages where we are naturally flavor compounds are developing. So this is again one of the chemical free as well as GRS category of flavors, which we directly convert our byproduct to the flavors. Next, this is the one of the important plastic PIH. We are also working with the collaboration with the some of the institution here, and some of the our lignocellulose and starch bearing and some other plant and animal fat, we are converting the PHA, and this PHA is very much useful for the bioplastic. So from byproduct and waste to the bioplastic is also one of the way to convert this waste to the wealth. So finally, come to the conclusion, specifically the our limitation is the technology. If technology is there, this technology is the high cost, that's why our product cost and utilization cost is very high, and that's why some entrepreneurs and some small industry are not promoting that conversion of this byproduct to the value added in different way. So if you develop a process technology for small operations, some byproduct management, which will be eco-friendly, not affect to the environment, easy and low cost products, definitely we can utilize these byproducts in the proper way. The byproduct utilization in food sector has a huge potential. You can and India can become the food hubs of the world after this post-COVID-19. And the food processing sector, which is now also running in the COVID period, this was the only sector which continuously working in the COVID or pre-COVID or post-COVID. We just expect it can grow with the over 25% annual growth of the next 2 years. So finally, if we utilize the product and buy product and convert our wastage to the wealth, and that I am very much sure that slogans will very recently true that Bahujan Sukhaya and Bahujan Hitaya. Next, and if you see there, just I want to convey this about the wastage. This wastage is a resource. Invest is effectively not waste in the environment. So if you see this picture, in this picture we are scanning our. If you see this picture, this is the last slide. If you see this picture, this is actually in waste. But if you see in the microscope eye of our wealth, our technology, very having a huge amount of wealth, so we can improve our technology, we can improve our country wealth by just converting this waste to wealth. Next.
Okay.
And next, please.